Probably the biggest thing I like is the fact that it's true multitasking. So, videos play in the background. It's not like an app switcher. It really is true multitasking. Obviously, it's touchscreen, 7-inch, weighs 9/10 of a pound, is 0.4 inches in width. So it's like a CD jewel case is the best thing we can compare it to. So the next biggest thing I like to show is the video quality. So we can go to the videos and play HD. So not only will this play HD videos, it will record HD, 1080p. There's a camera up here, a camera on the back, and it will record in HD. So you can make your own HD videos. The bezel is also a touch. So what I can do is start here at the BlackBerry logo and swipe up, minimize it. Notice that it continues to run while I can go to, maybe look at my pictures. And then what I can do is swipe from the right and go from my open apps to my open apps. And notice that video was still running the whole time. To get rid of something, I just grab it and flick it off the screen just like that. It's very, very simple. Internet, so you get pinch to zoom, just like you'd expect. Very intuitive, very responsive, as you can see. Different websites like YouTube is probably a good example. It's not a YouTube app, it's the actual site we're going to right now. So you can see videos playing in HD if it's supported for the YouTube video. It starts playing pretty quickly as well. Wi-Fi unit at launch, and then we just announced yesterday partnership with Sprint, so 4G in the summertime device will be out. So I can go here, we have flash-based games using the accelerometer.
Still running that video.
Still running that video in the background. Notice there's no hiccups or anything like that because of the dual core processor. See some other things that I can show you.
Do you always have to start from the bezel when you're navigating like that?
What example are you referring to?
When you were swiping across the screen, you were starting from the black part of the bezel?
No, not for that. So this, I can just go right through this. But if I'm in an app and I want to minimize it, I start from the bottom of the bezel and I just move it up like that.
Now, do you have to do it in the center? Or could you do it from the right or the left?
That's a good question. I don't think it matters. It doesn't matter.
Okay.
I think by just habit, I started in the center, but it doesn't really matter. Also, like when you're browsing, you can swipe from the top of the bezel, and then you can open up a new tab and go to another, have multiple websites running. Absolutely. I don't think I showed you the camera yet.
It's an expandable memory, right?
Not expandable per se. It'll be a 16 GB, a 32 GB, and a 64 GB model that we'll launch. Right now we're seeing the camera, so right now we're looking at the back camera. That's why you don't see much. But right here in the lower right, if I just click this button, we now have the front camera. The video is done playing, so we can swipe that away. Of course, music capability. So, very easy to navigate. There's all my songs, the album covers, book applications. There's 2 to 3 million books available, and a lot of them are free. But regardless of free or not, you can do portrait or landscape, and you can read your book and swipe the screen to go from page to page.
Now, do you know much about the App Store, the BlackBerry App Store?
Yeah.
A lot of the apps that they have on there are regulated for smaller screens. Are they kind of upscale them, or are they just...
Yeah, so when you see the apps available on Apple for this are going to be completely different than what's on Apple for the devices, because they're, now they have Flash that they can encode in, Adobe Air that they can use, HTML5, things that the devices don't support. So you're going to see a completely different suite of apps that come out. We'll be announcing partners in the near future.
Okay.
But right now, it'll come with some basic apps.
So it's not that the people's apps that are already out there will just be blown up. They'll have to
It's specific built from this. So you'll see that too, probably. But then you're also going to see brand new apps built from the ground up for the playbook. It's really easy to code for, too. So it's not going to be a big deal. You're going to see apps come out pretty quickly and easily for this device. Nothing really to announce. launched just yet. Sheet to go, Word to go, Slideshow to go, a couple things to mention there. So I can edit on my device, and of course pinch to zoom. So I can, you know, so we've looked at things for teenagers, we've looked at things for kids, now we're looking at things for more the business professional. I can just go to a specific cell, swipe from the lower left of the screen, and then get to my keyboard, and then, you know, change something in that particular cell, and then
let me see you swipe again, bring that keyboard up.
Sure, so you start from the lower left, and swipe diagonal, and that's it, and make it go away like this, and then make that go away. And then what else is cool is, as we're showing, you show it's mirror mode on HD, there's HDMI out, so this will just plug into a TV and immediately start working. Notice it's mirror mode, but what else you can do is, like in PowerPoint, I can't really demo this just yet, but what you can do, not only is do a presentation from PowerPoint, but instead of just mirror mode, you can have your speaker notes here while this slide is up here. So you're doing your presentation and you're reading your notes, but they're seeing the slide, and you're just swiping from slide to slide, and that's it.
Can I see the photo app?
Yeah, sure, absolutely. So these are just, you know, built-in photos, and then of course pinching to zoom, and then swiping to go from. Looks like you'd expect from a photo app.
Now people are just going to have to get used to the swipe gestures, like where they are.
Yeah, well, I had my first time ever with this week. It took me about 15 minutes, and I was like, I'm ready to go. I had no experience with this yet until this week, and I learned it in 15 minutes. So it really, there's really not a whole lot to learn. It's just swiping here, moving your finger, you know, here, and then on the sides. But I'd say 15, maybe 30 minutes, you pretty much know everything you can do.
Now, if I'm watching a movie or a YouTube video with a YouTube app,
yeah,
and I want to hold it around the bezel, and let's say I have slippery fingers and I'm sliding here and there, is that portion locked when I'm watching a movie or a video?
It's not that sensitive, I guess the best way. So you could do that and not have to worry about it. You have to really make a compelling gesture to do it. So it's not like something you could accidentally do. You have to really make a specific gesture to do something. So it's really not going to be an issue. And one thing that we're not showing right here, but on the other side right there, is pairing with the BlackBerry and the things you can do with it. So you can check your email here, your calendar, your contacts, anything that's on your BlackBerry, in five or six different things, and check it out on your BlackBerry Messenger, so you can start a conversation here, finish it on your device, et cetera. Tether using the BlackBerry as your modem. So if you don't have Wi-Fi, but you have a tethering package with your carrier, and you got access to the internet.
Thanks. Appreciate the tour. Question.